Okay, in the third video, I'm going to explain how to get the corresponding grade on your score based on the grading scale following. Okay, so first I'm going to be presenting it in three different ways. First thing, I'm going to use if function. Second time, I'm going to be using VLOOKUP function. Third time, I'm going to be using INDEX plus MATCH function. Okay, in doing so, I'm going to be explaining a little bit more on all these functions. Okay, so first one is, which is the easiest one, and I'm going to be using f function here. Okay, so this is fairly simple way to do that. Okay, but it's prone to error. Okay, because of the complicatedness. So first argument is the logical test. We are trying to. I'm sorry. I think I'm. Made a mistake here. So let me do it again. So first argument is logical test. I'm trying to compare whether B1 is larger than this value. Okay, if it is, please return this contents. Okay, if it is false, let's get started something new. Okay, f function, and then do it here. Click here, click here. It's gonna start new. Again, this is larger than this value. Okay, if it's true, give us this. If it's not, let's get started something new. And okay, again, Q3 equal to this value right here. If it is, if true, then is C. Okay, and if it is not, we do a new thing again. So click inside of parentheses here equal to this value this time. And if it is true, return this. If it is not, let's return this. Okay, so previously I think I have typed myself for all these things, but this time I try to click the cells instead of typing the actual thing here. I just click the cell, so cell coordinate is being used for all these different positions. So this will still do the job. Okay, got B here. So what happens if I put 59 here? Okay, think I made a mistake here. So for last thing, it should be B9. Okay, B9 is A9. I'm sorry, A9. Good, 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 good. So it's got an F. Yeah, it's actually good for letting you guys to see what's the mistake I have made. Okay, as we're trying to work together to solve problem, we actually can learn something to prevent making your own mistake. So let's do 60 this time. Okay, it's pretty rigorous. 98, it's got an A. So 67, it's got a D. So it's actually working pretty well. This is F. Okay, so one thing you hate about F is that you have to write a very, very sophisticated nested if functions. Okay, but next for next one, we're going to convert this. We're going to do the same thing this time with the VLOOKUP function. Okay, so VLOOKUP function. Let me finish this one first, and then go ahead and explain everything here. This is the value we're trying to look up. Okay, this is table array, which are to return from the second column. Okay, boom. Oh no, what's wrong here? Second column, VLOOKUP. Okay, I think I made a very embarrassing mistake here. But it's good chance for you guys to take a look. What's the mistake I have made here? Okay, why this will cause an not available error here? Okay, let's open up the VLOOKUP argument box. Let's take a look. Okay, so looks for a value in the leftmost column of a table. So try to look up this 89 from the leftmost of table. There's nothing matches, okay, because I have flipped the order. Okay, that's the reason why it shows that error here. Okay, it's good to know. That's good to know. I think I was spending too much time on this video. I think I got a little tired. Okay, so let's do it again. Let's write all over again. VLOOKUP, and this is a lookup value, and the table is what we're looking for, and from second column we're closing it. Boom! This time we got it right. Right? This time we got it right. And let's say, what if I'm gonna put 4 here? It's gonna return us 4. What if 56? Still 65. Okay, 76. 87, okay, 97, okay. So I think we got it right. So let me just take a little time here to try to explain this VLOOKUP function a little bit more, okay, a little bit more, especially about the argument that we have omitted here. Okay, we actually have omitted number 4 argument. Okay, we have actually omitted number 4 argument. It's because VLOOKUP is actually it actually allows us to omit it sometimes, because once we omit it, it's going to put true for us instead. Okay, it's going to put true by default. So what does it mean is that, what does it mean? Okay, messing it up. Okay, what does it mean is that when you put true here, okay, it's not going to looking for the value that's exactly like 97. Okay, instead, it's going to looking for it's going to return the next smallest value. In this case, is 90, right? So what happens when we put false here? What happens when we put false here? Okay, it's not going to get us anything because we're starting to looking for something that's exactly like this. But there's nothing, right? Unless you got 90 here, okay? But since we have 79, we need to formulate our function in such a way that we're looking for a range, and then return the number that is smaller than, okay, what we're looking for. So we need to make it either to put it true or either to eliminate, okay? When we don't write it, it's going to put true for us automatically. Okay, you got this clear? So the key here, I think all of you are pretty familiar with the VLOOKUP function, but with this particular example, I just want to emphasize the importance of true, which is the number 4 argument. Sometimes the last argument, okay, although we haven't spent a lot of time learning it, but it's very, very important. So like next one, index and match function, especially in match function, the last one is actually very, very important. Last argument can actually very, very important. So in this particular example, what I'm trying to do is that I'm going to using match function and index function to get a corresponding grade for the score listed here. So let's kind of do a quick review here with the index function first, since index is the easiest one here. So before we get started, let me put a grading scale here. Grading scale, and let's see, grading scale 0, 60, 70, 80, 90. Okay, this is F, D, C, B, A. Okay, we're good. Okay. So, for example, 89, okay? By just taking a look at it, you know that 89 is really belong to this range right here. So, smallest value, okay, from here is actually 80. Therefore, it's going to likely return number B here. So, how do you actually use index value to display B? Okay, how do you actually use index value, index function to display B? So 1, 2, 3, 4, fourth row, second column, and this is B. Okay, so this is what index function has helped us to do. But how do you actually make this row number change as your score changes? Okay, that's when we need match function. Let's go back here. Take a look at match function. So what match function does is that match function is going to return us the relative row number in a given array, okay? In a given array that meets your condition. So, okay, let's take a look this time. So, for example, I'm trying to looking for trying to looking for this. So, okay, let me do it here. So, following section, okay, is actually dedicated to demonstrate the match function. So you can actually see how important the function is, that how desperate I want you to understand how this match function actually work. Okay, you see I have three mysterious black box here. Okay, I'm gonna flip it open just in a minute. Okay, so let's take a look here. So match function is, as I said, match function is returning the relative row number, okay, from the given array that satisfies our condition. So, for example, this array right here. When trying to look up number 2, where is the relative row number the number 2 has here? Okay, let me just revise it. Let's put number 5 so there's no duplicate here. There's no duplicate here. So by just taking a look at it, we understand that number 2 is actually the third row. So I'm gonna complete this with a match function. So lookup value this, lookup array is this, and okay, we used 0 in our first example. Okay, I'm going to explain what 0 means here. I said, I think I remember I said that actually the third argument takes three different values only. Okay, 0, 1, minus 1. This is case of 0. Okay, this is case of 0. What does it mean when you have 0? When you have 0 as a third argument in your match function. Okay, so let me flip it open. What does it mean when you have 0 here? Okay, it returns relative row number of the first exact match. And when you sort it, there's no particular order is required. So for example here, what is the row number that matches number 2? What is the first row number that matches number 2 here? Of course, it's 3. 1, 2, 3. Therefore, match function returned 3 here. What if we change this number 4 row into number 2? Is it still going to return number 3 or number 4? Since this is returning first exact match, therefore it's going to return us number 3 here. It's not going to change actually. It's looking for the first exact match. So what happens if we have 2 here? I think it's going to return us number 1, right? Since this is our first exact match. Okay, so this is what we have as what we when we have 0 as the third argument. Let's move on to next example right here. So this time I'm going to be using number 1 as a third argument instead of number 0. Okay, so match, I'm going to look up number 2 from this given array. Okay, and we are putting number 1 as our third arguments. So third arguments, third is less than. So what does number 1 do? Let's take a look. Let's observe. 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. It appears that it has returned us, okay, it has returned us the last one that is greater or equal to number 1. Okay, last one that is greater than or equal to number 2. So what if I put 3 here? What if I put 3 here instead of number 2? Is it going to return us number 3? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is it going to return us number 5 here? I think. Answer is yes. What if I put number 2.5 here? It's going to return us number 4 because it returns us relative row number of last less or equal value. Okay? So this is actually last one that is less than or equal to number 2.5. Okay, so here we have catch. Your data has to be organized in an ascending order. So in terms of sorting, it is best when you have a ascending ordered data here. Okay, so it doesn't have to be always ascending order, but it's at best It works most efficiently when you have an ascending order, the data. Okay, so this is when we have number one as the third argument. So our last one is when we have number minus one as the third argument here. As you can see, I have descending order number. This is where the number minus one as a third argument functions the most efficiently. So let's take a look at here, match function. Match function, and looking up number two from this array, from this array, and we're going to use minus one here. Okay, so let's take a look what it has returned. What did it return? So it's returning us to let's it returned 1, 2, 3, 4. It returned us that equal value. Okay, number of row that contains the equal value. Let's put 3 here instead. See what happens. So as I put 3 here, it has returned us the first smaller or equal value. Did I make it right? And so it returned the row number that contains the first smaller or equal to number 3. So this is number 2 here. So it has returned, okay, it has returned the first row number that contains greater than or l equal to the value we're looking at. Okay, so this is let me open it. So relative row number of first greater than or equal to value, okay, required descending order. So we have all three arguments explained here. So how do we actually, based on this, trying to solve the grading scale problem here? So for example, well, of course you can always let me, okay. You can either using ascending order scale, or you can either to use descending order scale. Okay, so let's say 100, 90, 80, 70, 60. Okay, let's put A, B, C, D, F. We're actually trying. Let what I'm actually trying to help you understand how to take advantage of this structured grading scale and this structured grading scale. Okay, of course, by putting different third argument. Okay, it's clear that we cannot use number 0 as a third argument in this case, but we're gonna try put number 1 first as a third argument because the data is in a ascending order. Okay, so let's get a match function first. So we're just looking up this value right here, and looking up array is of course this. Okay, and match type is number 1. See if it works. As we may recall, number 1 returns the relative row number of last less or equal value. Last less or equal value. It sounds a lot like VLOOKUP function. Last less or equal value right here. So what's the actually last less than or equal to value compared to 89? Considering 89 in this array, what is the last less than or equal to value? Of course, it's 80, right? So it's going to return number 4. That's actually what we are looking for. I think when we have number 1 as the third arguments, the grading scale can be presented just like VLOOKUP function. Okay, so I'm just gonna embed it. I'm just gonna embed it into this to replace the second argument. Think it will work. Okay, so let's consider second case here. Let's consider second occasion here. Is it formulated in a correct manner? So we're still gonna looking for 89 here, and still trying to put grade here. Okay, so match. I'm sorry. Let's put index first. Index first, and in this index, so 89 is actually belongs to B grade, right? In B grade. So 89, number, second row, second column. Oops, I made a mistake, sorry. It has to be matrix, right? It has to be matrix. So okay. Now it's our task to find out how to utilize, take advantage of a match function here. So looking at this value here, okay, and then we want to use minus 1 here. So how do we actually return number 2 here? So as you may recall, minus 1, okay, minus 1 is actually returns us the relative real number of first greater than or equal to value. So in order to take advantage of these characteristics, let's take a look at here. So it looks like it got it right this time, okay? But what if 90, but still returns B, which is not correct, okay? As you may recall, when we have minus 1 as the third argument, it's going to return us first greater than or equal to value, okay? So in order to take that advantage, I think it's better for us to formulate in this fashion. Let's take a look. Okay, I see some changes. 69, 99, and just say if 0 works this time. So since this is returning the first greater than, okay, first greater than or equal to. So in this array, actually this is actually the first greater than or equal to number considering 90, right? Is there any other thing greater than 90? There's none. Okay, there's none. So what if I put 89, 99 here? Which one is the first greater value here? It's actually this. So it's going to, probably it's going to return number 2 for us. I was correct. So what if I have 59 here? So what if I have 59 here? Okay, so here, I probably have to revise a little bit. So is there anything greater than actually 59 here? So only you have this way, it's going to return the right scale. So I'm just going to put it back there, okay, to replace second argument. Okay, I think now we have everything in place. Okay, so no matter how you manipulate value right here, it's going to return us the correct number. Just you need to remember all these different rules. When number 1, number 0, number 1, number minus 1, in each case, what does it return? So you need to be crystal clear about all these different occasions. Okay?